On today's show, VW delays the introduction of the new Phaeton. Is the car doomed? Hyundai teases the new Elantra, and a look at a whole new approach to building a car. All that and more coming right up on Autoline Daily. This is Autoline Daily for August 21st of 2015. Car sales in the American market are going strong, so it's not surprising to see automakers are cranking out vehicles to keep up with demand. Wards reports that production in North America hit nearly 1.3 million units in July, up 4.5% from a year ago and the highest total ever for the month. Trucks led the way with a 6% increase thanks to the red-hot crossover segment. CUV production was up 16% last month. Pickup truck production actually slipped slightly in July, and passenger cars saw modest growth. It's truly amazing to see that only 5 years after the biggest collapse in production, a new production record has been set. The Phaeton has pretty much been a sales disaster for Volkswagen, mostly because no one wants to pay $100,000 for a VW. The car was a pet project of former chairman Ferdinand Piëch, but now that he's no longer running the company, VW has decided to delay the introduction of the new model. Bloomberg reports that the company is reworking the car to lower production and material costs. Well, here's our Autoline insight. With Piëch out at VW, this car is doomed. It probably would have been canceled altogether, except that all the tooling was already ordered. In an effort to speed up repairs for its vehicles affected by Takata airbags, Toyota is considering tapping 3 additional suppliers to boost supply. It's looking at using inflators from Autoliv, Dicel, and just last month the automaker asked Nippon Kayaku to increase production to supply it with 13 million airbags from July of next year through 2020. We would not be surprised to see more automakers follow suit. We'll be back with more right after this.
Autoline Daily is brought to you by Bridgestone Tires, your journey, our passion. Dow Automotive Systems, breakthrough technologies for lightweight vehicles. Hyundai, learn more at Hyundai.com. And by Pure Michigan, leading the automotive world in intelligent connected vehicles. We run on brain power.
A week ago, we showed you the new Mercedes C-Class Coupe, and now the automaker is giving us a look at the performance AMG model. And like any AMG model, it's not too hard to distinguish the C63 from its less powerful brethren. Due to an increased width in the front and rear axles, the two cars only share the same doors, roof, and trunk lid. The rest has been reworked to accommodate the wider track. Lurking under the hood is a twin-turbo 4-liter V8 engine that kicks out nearly 470 horsepower, and that's just for the standard trim. The S model pumps out over 500 horsepower. Moving to the inside, there are of course high-grade materials throughout, as well as numerous AMG-specific controls. While these are just the highlights, click on the headline in today's transcript to learn more about the C63. Hyundai just gave a sneak peek at the new Elantra. Even though it's just a sketch, you can see it's sleeker than the current model and adopts Hyundai's hexagonal grille. The Elantra is an important car for Hyundai in the American market. Despite most automakers having trouble selling small cars, sales of the Elantra are up 12%, and it's the best-selling model in the company's lineup. The new Elantra debuts at the LA Auto Show in November. Coming up next, Ford shows off the trailworthiness of the new Raptor and a look at a company that's combining 3D printing and lightweighting. Yesterday we told you about how Toyota improved the Tacoma's off-road capabilities, and now Ford is revealing details about its off-road pickup, the Raptor. Engineers are busy on northern Michigan trails testing a prototype with components from both the new model and the 2015 F-150. Ford says the 2017 Raptor has better ground clearance than the old one and will come standard with new 3-inch Fox Racing shocks. It also comes with a new four-wheel drive torque on demand transfer case that further improves its performance on the trail. Add it all up, and Ford says the new Raptor is more off-road capable than the previous model. For those interested, it will be available in the fall of 2016. You know, lightweighting is one of the most important trends in the automotive industry today. So is 3D printing. And a company called EDAG is putting the two together. We first reported about the company in December of last year, but at the time, it had only produced a passenger cell of a vehicle. Now it has moved on to a whole car with a concept called the Light Cocoon. Let's take a look at how they get it done. They start by printing the structure of a car, but in this case, the structure has a bionic look to it. It almost looks as if it was grown in nature, and that's because they took inspiration from the leaf of a tree. First, EDAG determined the ideal geometrical structure using computer-aided engineering to identify all the load paths. Then, they only print out those load paths, resulting in the strongest structure with the least amount of material. In a way, this is the modern-day equivalent of the Maserati Birdcage race car, only far more sophisticated. To draw even more attention to this concept, EDAG gave it a fabric body that can be backlit, and it certainly is eye-grabbing. EDAG is a German company that's been around for 46 years, developing new ideas for the aviation and automotive industries. And this is an idea that really points towards a new way to build cars, but maybe not for another decade. That wraps up today's show. Thanks for watching, and have a great weekend.
Wards is the industry leader for news, data, and analysis. That's why companies across the globe subscribe to our premium service, maybe even your own. Log in for subscriber access now. Check your company's intranet for details and rely on wardsauto.com to keep you informed.